Welcome to the Otii Quick Start series. In this video, you will discover how to set up a UART recording to debug and control embedded or IoT devices in real time. If the device under test has UART pins available, you can easily connect it to the Otii hardware to debug log messages in real time and correlate them with the channel's measurements. Having the main connectors already connected to the device under test, then connect UART pins between the Otii hardware expansion port and the device under test. UART communication can be bidirectional. Either logs can be received from the device under test or commands can be sent to the device under test. To do this, both the RX and TX pins must be connected between both devices. Make sure to also connect digital ground. This is especially important for Otii Ace Pro due to that expansion port is isolated from the main port. Make sure to remove any power source the device under test may have, either a connected battery or a USB power connection. We highly recommend you to check out the documentation to see the expansion pins details on both Otii Arc Pro and Otii Ace Pro. Add your Otii hardware if it has not already been added to the project, and set up the general settings for the device under test based on its technical requirements, such as voltage, digital voltage, and overcurrent protection. Enable the current and voltage channels to correlate them with the UART logs later. Under the UART tab, define the baud rate to establish the serial communication between the device under test and the Otii hardware. Then, enable the reading by clicking the UART log button. Once activated, the log console is automatically displayed at the bottom of the OT3 and listed under the measurement tab. Keep in mind that the UART logs will be only being shown in the real time on the log console when a recording is active and the device is switched on. The log console shows data from either the UART pins of the Otii hardware or from a third-party USB UART. Once you have received data, you can filter the logs. Just write the desired message to be found, and it will filter out the messages logged over the time. Also, you can transmit data from the console to the device under test using the TX data field, making an ideal interface for sending AT commands or customized configuration to the device under test. For example, for AT commands, turning on echo in your device under test also shows what message that was being sent together with the response. Keeping time, traceability is important when debugging your system. In Otii, you can activate different options to keep track of this. Show time, we show the execution time from when the recording started. Show wall time, we show you the date and time on which the message has been received. Show time diff, we show the time difference between the log message and the previous one. Correlating measurement behaviors with logs is key to a comprehensive analysis. Within these features, you can mark an area in the graph and all the UART messages that occur in this time frame are marked in the UART log. You can also do the opposite and mark one or several messages in the UART log. If you select one message, 1 millisecond will be highlighted on the graph. At the same time, the current graph for that time frame is marked. If you are looking to select multiple messages with the console log, use Shift and click or Shift arrow up, down. Remember to disable the UART logs messages in the firmware when your device is ready for production to avoid wasting unnecessary energy. That's it for starting with the UART recordings for debugging with Otii product suite. For more tips and advanced features, check out our next video to master Otii usage, or visit docs.coited.com for further details. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to stay tuned for Coitec latest content.